بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله. We begin our lesson by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we pray that Allah bless us and give forgiveness and answer any of our prayers, and inshallah by the barakah of this lesson, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all difficulties and trials and tribulations in dunya and in akhirah, and bless us with husnul khatima. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Before any we start our lesson, and just need to recap some of the things any that I mentioned in the last lesson. We have entered any into the chapter that is called al-mu'arifat in the sulam of al-imam al-akhdari, which inshallah any we will go into it any later. This particular chapter, Al-Mu'arifat, basically the author is speaking about types of definitions. Types of definitions, and he began by speaking about there are three types. So, namely, in Arabic we have the Al-Had, number two, we have Al-Rasm, and then we have Lafzi. So, these are the three types of definition that is mentioned by the author. What is the most important from these definitions is the first one, that is the definition based on Al-Had. So when we speak about Al-Had, there are two main elements. Number one is jinns, and you have the jinns, and you have the fasl. And this is the thing that we have been speaking since we spoke about Kulliyatul Khamsa, the five universal principles. I mentioned many a times that the purpose of studying the five universal principles, it is to understand how to make good definitions. And the best type of definition is the had, and the had consists of jinns and fasl. Jinns, the genus, and the differentia. So these are the two things from the five universal concepts. So whenever you have in a particular definition, you have the genus, and then you have the differentia, that is the fossil, and both of these things, as what we mentioned, these are the characteristics of a particular definition that speaks about zati. It is based on the essence of a particular thing, not the attribute, because there is a difference between the essence of a particular thing and the attribute of a particular thing. So let me just recap. Just to explain again for those who are first time learning mantiq, for example, you might find this strange and you might find this something maybe it's difficult. But basically, when we speak about zati and aradi, when we speak about jinns and fasl, we are speaking about zat. We are speaking about the essence of things. Whereas another part is the attribute. So there is a difference between the essence and the attribute. A simple example this is an essence. This is that. The color of this particular thing is an attribute, or we call it an accident. The height of this particular thing is the accident. But the essence is what we meant by that. So in definition, when we speak about the genus and the fossil, the genus and fossil, this is basically concentrating on speaking about the essence of things. An example as what we mentioned many a times is human beings for example. The definition of al-insan is hayawanu natiq. This is an example of jinns and fasl. Al-hayawan, it is a class of beings that consists of human beings and cows and horses and all these things. So it speaks about the essence of this particular being, al-hayawan. And then we have the differentia, the thing that differentiates between human beings and the rest of the members within the same class of hayawaniya or hayawan. That is an-natiq, that human beings possess the intellectual capacity to think and to understand. So this is fossil, and it also speaks about the essence of insan, because this intellectual any capacity any is within the essence any of the human beings. Whereas laughter is an accident, walking any is an accident, running any is an accident, falling sick any is an accident, being healthy any is an accident. So it is something that clings any to the essence, if you can name it as, is something that, that clings any to the essence. Why any existing any important? Now this, if you understand the meaning any of jinns, you understand the meaning of fossil, and you understand the meaning that is related any to zat, to essence, and there are certain things any that are related any to the accidents or attributes. Now this is an important thing any for us any to understand definitions, because good definitions any speaks any about the essence of things. Good definition and it speaks any about the essence of things, and this is what in had is all about. The first any type of definition, al had any is consists any of al jins wal fasl, and then you have any the second type any of definition that is called a rasm, and rasm you have jins and khas, jins and khas. Khas any goes back any to the attributes. So now, for example, any if you ask, what is any definition any of insan? I say the definition any of insan is al-hayawanu dahiq. Yani it is a being that laughs, a being any that has the capacity to laugh. Taib, this laughter, is it any an essence any or accident? Is laughter any an accident or an essence? Is laughter any part of the essence any of human beings? No, yani it is an accident. It is an attribute that insan any insan has the ability any to laugh, and laughter any is part any of the things any that can be done any by insan. Likewise, any walking any is an accident. Walking any is an accident. Moving any is an accident. Running any is an accident. So if I define any something by the genus, and instead any of putting the differential any, I put any an accident that is specific any to that particular thing any that I'm defining. Now this is the meaning of defining any by using the genus and a specific any accident. That is any the khas. So accidents any, there are two types. We have any the specific any accident, and we have the general any accident. So pertaining to human beings any, for example, when we say a specific any accident, we can, for example, we say laughter. Laughter any specific any to insan, because the rest any of the beings under the class any of hayawan, they do not laugh. They do not any have any attribute any of laughing. Whereas any human beings has any the ability to laugh. So this is any the thing that differentiate human beings any from the rest of the members any within any class any of hayawan. But this particular accident that is specific any to human beings, the fact that it is not any from the jinns, it is not any from the essence, correct or not? It is from not from the essence, but it is an attribute. So when it is an attribute, there is a shortcoming in using attributes in definition. There is a shortcoming in using any attributes in definition. And what is any the best type of definition is to use any definitions any that speaks any about the essence any of the thing that is described, not any using any the accident. So the moment any you use any an accident, now there is any shortcoming any in the definition. So in mantiq any we call it rasm. Rasm consists any of two things. One any is a jins, and the other one any is al khas, that is a specific accident. So what is any the difference any between had and rasm? The difference any is al had, it consists any of jins and fasl, and both goes back any to speak any about the essence. Whereas al rasm, it goes back any to jins and khas, that is a specific any accident any of that particular thing any that is any described. Naam. And then any we have any the third type any of definition that is called lafzi. So lafzi any is basically any we use synonyms. Lafzi any we use synonyms. For example, if a person any asks you any, for example, what is any the definition, what is the meaning any of beautiful, for example? What is the meaning any of beautiful? So I say the meaning any of beautiful any is attractive. Yani this is any a kind any of synonym. I'm using any another word that carries any about the same meaning. I'm using any another word that carries any about the same meaning. And if, for example, if a person asks what is the meaning any of clever, I say the meaning is intelligent. The meaning any of clever is intelligent. What is the meaning any of car? So I say, for example, it is a vehicle. So I'm using any words that are based any on synonyms. So last time any we mentioned in mantik any we call it taraduf. Yani there are certain words that are different, but they carry any the same meaning. So in mantik any, for example, we have the word ayn. We have any the word any, for example, asad. Then we have qaswara. Then we have laith. Yani it is different words, but it carries any the same meaning. So when it comes any to definition and based on lafzi, basically I replace that particular I replace any the word that carries any the same meaning as the thing that is being defined. So this is any the third type of definitions any in mantiq. So the definitions any in mantiq any are divided any into three types. Number one is al-had, number two is al-rasm, number three is lafzi. So now anyway, we just go into our slides and inshallah. So now any the author any mention. So this basically the chapter any Ma'rifat. So the author any began any by saying hold on. Mu'arifun ila salasatin qusim. Haddun wa rasmiyun wa lafziyun ulim. So these are the three types. And he basically said that the mu'arif, yani the things and that defines, they are of three types. The types and of definitions that we can use to define things. So either it is had, rasm, or lafzi. And then he mentioned, falhaddu bil jinsi wa faslin waqa'a. So this is what I explained earlier, yani as a revision of what I mentioned yani last week also. So when it comes to had, there are two things. One is the jins and the other one is fasl. Wa rasmu, whereas any for rasam, where this is any the second type any of definition, bil jinsi wa khasatin ma'a. Yani it is with the genus and the specific any accident, that is a khas. So an example any will be al insan huwa al hayawanu dahik. It is a being any that laughs. This is a meaning any of rasm. Definition any in terms any of rasm. Definition any in terms any of rasm. Because why? Because any they are made up of two elements. Any number one any is the genus, and the other one any is the specific any accident. Naam. And then any he mentioned any after that. وناقص الحد بفصل أو مع جنس بعيد لا قريب وقع. So now when he mentioned that when comes any to had, now we go back any to had. So al had, there are two types. And one is al haddu tam, the other one is al haddu naqis. Al haddu tam, and the other one is had al naqis. So when we say al-haddu tam, we speak any about the near genus, using any the near genus and the differentia, fasl. So this is the meaning of al-had at-tam, whereas al-haddu naqis, I use any afar genus. In our two, three lessons any back, we mentioned any that genus any they are the near genus and we have any afar genus. For example, human beings and animals, they are under the genes of Hayawan. And Hayawan any is under the genus of substance. The Hayawan is under the genus any of body, jism. And jism any is under the genus any of substance. So for example, any if I define human beings by saying any that human beings is al jismun natiq. If I say human beings any is al-jismun natiq, this is called al-haddu naqis. Why any it is called any haddu naqis? Because any I'm using any a genus any that is far. Instead any of using saying hayawan any which is the nearest any genus any to insan, I'm using any a further any genus. I say insan is al jismun natiq. So this is any a far genus. When I use any a far genus, there are many other things any that I have made any to enter into the class. Because any by saying jism, any a body any can be a living thing and it can be non any living thing. So now any if I say a body any that possess an intellectual any capacity, a body any that possess an intellectual any capacity. So there is a shortcoming any in this kind of definition because I'm using any a genus any that is far. What is correct any in definitions is that I must always any observe the nearest any genus, to use any the nearest any genus. So when I want to define any human beings, I need to use the nearest any genus any to human beings. That is al-hayawan, being. This is any the nearest any to human beings. So if I use any the nearest any genus, and then any I use any the fossil, now this is al-haddu tam. This is any the complete definition. But when if I use any a far genus, whether I use a far genus or middle any genus, any for example, after hayawan and you have jism, after jism and you have substance. So if I use the furthest any genus, for example, I use substance, and I say al insan huwa al jawharun natiq. I use any the word jawhar. This is any the genus above any jism, any for example. Now this is any worse any than saying al insan huwa al jismun natiq. So the further any I go any in genus, the more any of a shortcoming any it is any to the definition. So basically, what is any important any in had is that we always any look for the nearest any genus, not the middle genus and not the further genus. It is any the nearest any genus. So when it comes any to human beings, it's al hayawan. So I cannot any be using jism, I cannot be using jawhar, because these are genuses any that are far from defining human beings any themselves. So this is what in the author he mentioned, wa naqisul haddi bi faslin wa ma'a jinsin ba'idin la qaribin waqa'a. So here the author yani is explaining haddu naqis. The author yani is explaining haddu naqis. So what is the meaning of haddu naqis? Al haddu naqis yani is to define yani something by using a far genus instead any of the near genus. So this is what any he said. Ma'a jinsin ba'in. Jinsin ba'in any safar genus. La karib. Not any using any the nearest any genus. So if you do so, then any you fell any into definition of al-haddu naqis. So the meaning any of haddu naqis, yani it is any to use any the far. It is use any to do use the far genus. Before any we go on any to speak about rasam, there is something any that I want to show that is the. Remember any we spoke any about the book Isaruji. So let us any go to the book any for a while. I just want to give you any inshallah any a clearer any picture inshallah on how any you look any at the things any that we have mentioned any so far. So this is any the Isaruji of Al Imam Al Abhari. So notice any when he speaks any about Al Kulli. That is the universal, the word any that carries any the universal meaning. He divide any al-kulli into zati and aradi. So this is what any you see any in Isaruji. So he said that kulli any is divided any into zati and aradi. So he said wazati. He said wazati. Imma maqulun fi jawabi ma huwa. بحسب شركة المحضة. So الذاتي يعني it goes on يعني to answer any the question what is it يعني what is the essence, and then يعني we have any the other one وأما العرضي يعني here يعني we speak any about the accidents. So the universal يعني word is divided يعني into the meaning يعني in terms يعني of the essence يعني of that particular word and the accident any of that particular word. So remember, when we speak about al-had, we are speaking any about the essence. That is the jins Yani is has a relation to the essence and the fasl. So this is the elements of the had. So when comes to the rasam, one yani is the jins, the other one yani is al khas. That is yani the accident that is specific yani to that particular thing. So basically yani if you look at Isaruji, it's exactly what is mentioned yani in Sulam. So he gave an example. He said, "Kadhahiki bil quwwati wal fi'li lil insan." Yani when he speaks any about al khas, the accident any that is specific, he gave any the example any of laughing when comes any to human beings. And then when you speak any about the accident that is general, al ardul am, remember yani we have the five universal concept. Number one, jinns. Then we have any fossil. Then we have jinns, now fossil, and then any we have the khas and am. Al khas, it is the accident that is specific. Al am, the accident that is any general. So when comes any to the accident that is general, any he said kal mutanaffis, yani like breathing. So this is an accident that is shared any by the members any of that class. So for example, when we say about al-hayawan and beings, so under beings, any we have human beings and we have animals. Human beings and we have any animals. What is any the common accident that is shared any by human beings and the animals? So he gave any the example of kal mutanafis. Mutanafis, yani having any the ability to breathe. So for example, human beings any can breathe. Cats any can breathe. Dogs any can breathe. Horses any can breathe. So the thing any about breathing any, it is an accident any that is am. Al-ardul am. It is an accident any that is any general. So there is a difference any between laughter and breathing. Laughter any, it is an accident that is specific any to insan, whereas breathing it is an accident that is general any to all any the beings under al-hayawan. So this is basically the difference any between jinns and fasl and al-khas any wal-am. Jinns and fasl and speaks any about the essence. Al-khas any wal-am speaks any about the accidents. So when you go back any to had, we have al-jinns any wal-fasl. Rasam, we have jinns wal-khas. So just like how any I mentioned any earlier, the second type any of definitions, rasam, that we use jinns and the other one any is al-khas. So now any we go back any to the sulam. So after any he mentioned about al-hadu naqis by using any the fa genus, then he mentioned wa naqisu rasmi. Rasam also any have two times. We have rasmu tam and rasmu naqis. So he said rasmu naqis bi khasatin faqat. For example, if I ask, what is the definition of insan? I say, the definition of insan, that insan has the ability to laugh. Dahik. Insan, the one who has ability any to laugh. Now, this is naqis. Rasam, that is naqis. Meaning, I don't mention the genus. I only mention the accident that is specific any to human being. So this is rasmun naqis bi khasatin faqat, yani by just using the specific accident. Aw ma'a jinsin ab'ad. Oh, yani I use any a genus but a far one. For example, I say al insan huwal jismud dahik. Instead any of saying al insan huwal hayawanu dahik, which is any rasmu tam, the complete any rasam, because I'm using a near genus. But now I'm using any further genus. I'm saying al-insan huwa jismu dahik. Now this is also naqis. This is also a shortcoming in rasm. Because why? Now I'm using a specific accident any to insan. But when it comes to the jinns, I'm using any a further genus. I'm not using any the nearer genus any to insan. So that is why any it becomes any a shortcoming. And then after that, any he mentioned about lafzi, he say, wama bi lafziyin ladayhim shuhira. tabdilu lafzin bi radifin ashhara. Yani when it comes into lafzi, we just change any the word. Instead any of saying for example beautiful, and we say attractive. Or we say handsome, any for example. So we just any change any the word, any it is basically like synonym. So this is any a kind of definition that is called as lafzi, because we just change the lafaz. We just change any the word. طيب inshallah, yani because any of time, we will stop here. Inshallah next week, any what I will do, if I remember, I will just any write some any few examples any before any we go on, inshallah ta'ala. So we have not any completed any this part on this chapter any on definitions. There are a few other things any left, and before any we enter into a very important part any of mantiq, that is a chapter of qadaya, the chapter of propositions, and then after that any we'll enter into syllogism, al-qiyas, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us any tawfiq and understanding. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.